5:15 a.m. The city is asleep. The wind has an edge to it. The cold slaps my face. I am tired, but I have a job to do.
What do you think?
I don't know. It don't sound like one of your regular arrest reports.
I'm writing a book!
Good morning.
I don't think so.
What's the matter?
I had hot flashes on the subway.
Isn't it something you eat for breakfast?
You don't get hot flashes from prunes.
Hey, Harris is writing a book.
What kind of book?
Fish wants to know what kind of book.
A novel.
A novel.
What kind of novel? You might ask.
No, Roger, you don't understand, man. The whole secret is oxygen in the blood. Listen, anything that makes your heart beat very fast, man.
It's got to be good for you.
Fine,
all right?
I'm just saying that handball is as good as your way.
But you can't dance with a handball.
But you don't got to listen to it talk, either. I mean, you get a dumb handball, you can just throw it in your locker.
Hey, Harris is writing a novel.
Oh, yeah? What kind of novel?
Why don't you ask him?
Harris, is that true you write a novel, man?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, no kidding, man. That's fantastic. What kind of novel is it?
It's a police novel. A week in the life of a New York City detective is seen through the eyes of me.
When did you decide to write a novel?
Last night. I was lying in bed, couldn't sleep, and I said to myself, you know, it's true. There are 8 million stories out there in this naked city, and I'm gonna sell one of them.
Morning, gentlemen.
Hey, Barney. Barney.
Anything happening I should know about?
I was writing a book.
Acapella, pretty good. I had in mind something more in the nature of a crime.
Coffee.
I would hesitate to call our coffee a crime. A shame, maybe. Oh, that's a crime.
Good morning.
What do we got in petty cash?
Around 50 bucks.
Check on it.
Yeah.
Good morning, Harry. What do you got that we can afford?
I got something very hot, Barney.
How much?
Very unique.
How much?
It'll cost you 100.
100? We never paid that kind of money for information before.
I never had this kind of information before.
Don't you ever do anything without thinking of the reward? Just because you're a good citizen?
No. Disgusting, huh? Really rotten?
Somewhere in there, yeah.
Informing on your fellow citizen is not a profession I would recommend to a friend.
Why don't you try something else?
I tried. I didn't have the feeling for it. Give me the 100 and let me get out of here.
Ooh, for that kind of money, Harry, we're gonna have to have a hint.
I offer two words. Charlie Jeffers.
Charlie Jeffers? That's not bad.
Not bad? He busted out of 5 prisons. Here. Elmira, Eastern New York Correctional, Clinton, Wallkill, and a couple of weeks ago he took a powder from Attica.
Where is he?
In your precinct.
50 now, 50 when we find him.
We got 42 bucks in petty cash.
42 now, 58 when we find him. Check the APV. See what you can dig up on Charlie Jeffers.
Okay.
In February.
Right.
Can I interest you in a couple of guys just in from Chicago?
What'd they do?
Nothing yet, but they got a big potential. And you can keep an eye on them for 25 bucks.
Let me know when they do something.
Sure. But I can't promise it to you for 25 bucks. You know, it depends on what they got going down.
Naturally.
Here it is. Charlie Jeffers went over the wall of Attica 3 weeks ago.
See you around, Harry.
I hate doing this.
Tried to sell his own brother for 50 bucks.
75. He gets out next June.
You're kidding.
Didn't you like him?
It wasn't bad.
And how about a little smut?
Bojo, Chano. Huh? You guys pick up Charlie Jeffers. All right, now be careful. He's probably armed and dangerous. Chapter one, page one.
Gotta start somewhere.
The city was asleep. I hope that's when you're gonna write it, because when the city's awake, we can use you around here.
Oh, absolutely.
It's that time of year, they're all over New York. They won't bother you.
What's up?
There's a lady complaining about a bird on the roof of a building across the street, for crying out loud.
You're a public servant. Got a description of the bird.
Describe the bird, lady.
Well, what'd she say?
It weighs about 180 pounds and it's wearing a wool hat.
Better send the car.
Barney! Hey, Barney, Barney! We have the right information, man. Here he is. Charlie Jeffers. You can't believe the excitement downstairs, man. Whew. You're a famous man, Mr. Jeffers.
I'm Captain Miller, Mr. Jeffers.
Captain Miller, how do you do, sir?
Until the Attorney General's office can arrange for a transfer, you'll be held here.
Charming.
And don't get any ideas, Jeffers. I mean, you may have walked out of Elmira and Attica, but this is the 12th precinct.
I have no intention of trying to leave here.
That's a comforting thought, Mr. Jeffers. Represents a change of attitude for you, doesn't it?
Well, I'm getting old, Captain. I'm not as angry as I used to be.
I understand.
I sent a patrol car out to check out the bird. Oh, Charlie Jeffers, how are you?
How do you do?
I recognize you from your APB circulars.
Sorry to hear that.
Well, I followed your career with a certain fascination, but then we do have the same sort of problem.
Oh, I don't know how that can be. I've been in prison for most of the past 35 years.
At least you can get out once in a while.
Oh, I see.
Mr. Jeffers, would you mind sitting down over here? We got some questions to ask you.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Mark.
The television station's on the phone. They want to know if they can come down and get pictures and interview with Jeffers.
Boy, news travels fast. You tell them they have to have permission from the Public Information Office of the Police Department and the Attorney General's office in Albany.
All right, Mr. Jeffers, could I have your full name, please?
Charles Evans Jeffers.
Date of birth?
April 14, 1919.
Permanent address?
Various.
Beautiful.
As Detective Harris, he's writing a book.
Oh.
How you doing?
Beautiful.
This way, please, Mr. Jeffers.
Yes, sir.
What's the address? Oh, okay, we'll get someone over there in a minute.
Hey, Barney. Listen, the patrol car just called in. They got some banana cake up on a rooftop with a pair of homemade wings trying to fly to New York.
That would be the 180-pound bird. I'll give him a hand. Take Harris with you. It'll do him some good to get away from his work.
Barney, the Attorney General's office called. They're sending some officers over to pick up Jeffers. They should be here in 3 or 4 hours.
Barney, huh? The public information officer is on his way down here from headquarters. He says no interviews on Jeffers until he gets...
Hey, Barney, look, there's all kinds of photographers, reporters downstairs. What do you want me to tell him?
All right, I'll take care of it. Look, get a couple of men in the hall.
Yeah.
I want to make...
All right. Pony Island, baby. I didn't want to disturb anyone. Sail away and never to return, so you can have the dishes, Mabel. So long, my Coney Island. Goodbye, my Coney Island. I said my Coney Island.
Police from 5 states were looking for him. It had been left to me to bring him in.
Me?
To him?
Mira, mentiroso. Mira, cara, eso me cae como un pulgante, chico, pero mira, he wasn't even there, Barney.
Poetic license.
Okay. And you can just sit right here in this chair here.
His name is Roland Goosey. We had to chase him over 3 buildings. A couple of times he got airborne, I swear.
And I'd have made it across the river if you minded your own business.
You also could have gotten killed.
Death has never been a deterrent. What's the name?
Miller. Captain Miller.
Obscurity is more terrifying than death, Captain Miller. Accomplishment's what's important. If I die in an attempt to accomplish something, who's the sufferer?
You are.
So?
Self-destruction happens to be against the law in this state, Mr. Gusick.
Archaic bubkus. If I fall from valor, it's my business.
Unless you fall on someone else. Should I take him over to Bellevue?
No, have him pick him up. I can't spare the man. Mr. Jeffers, I was just talking to some of the reporters downstairs. They tell me that you've spent 30 years in jail for stealing one automobile.
It was one hell of a car.
1 to 5 grand larceny auto and 25 years accumulated escape time?
A compound interest, you might call it.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
What'd you get for a cup of coffee?
I'd prefer tea, please.
Okay, Mr. Gusick, we're going to go downstairs.
Why?
Well, we have to take a picture of you and a picture of your fingers.
Stop talking to me as if I were a child. I am an engineer.
Okay, Mr. Gusick, we'll go down and find you a choo-choo.
It wasn't necessary, Wojo.
Sorry.
He thinks I got these wings out of a box of Cracker Jacks. This is aerodynamic engineering. This is not Chazarai. These were designed to give me the configurations of a thrush. My body happens to be a perfect airfoil.
Let's go.
We're finished as a culture. Do you know that? Where courage is a sickness and imagination is a crime, culture is dead. The minute we start spitting on pioneers, we've had it. Be careful with those wings. They are going to the Smithsonian.
So am I.
Yeah, Mr. Jeffers.
Thank you, Captain.
You know, it's hard for me to understand how an intelligent man like you could allow himself to be parlayed into so much trouble.
Well, logical consequences are the scarecrows of fools and the beacons of wise men.
This cat is dynamite. I'm gonna write that down.
It appears you found an admirer.
Do me a favor. Don't tell him it comes from Aldous Huxley until after I leave.
You know, it seems to me that if you just stayed put for a while, you could avoid all this difficulty.
No, I am by nature an impatient man, Captain.
But you're also a realist.
Well, the secret of being able to serve time is to accept the circumstance. To resign yourself to the fact that escape is impossible. Well, the more I escaped, the more difficult it became to accept that philosophy. Prison became increasingly unbearable because it became increasingly unnecessary.
But you always got caught.
Well, nobody is perfect.
What about this time? You try again?
I don't know. It isn't nearly as interesting outside as it used to be. I suppose these last few escapes were merely for the sake of the doing.
Why don't you just sit it out for a while? Try for parole.
Maybe I will this time. Certainly the challenge is no longer there. Perhaps this time I'm going to have to be practical and, yes, very, very bored.
Now, you really got some nerve, man.
I, me, myself, I.
Hey, man, it's fiction. You always use first person singular in fiction. Huh? Well, next time you and me, we find ourselves in an alley with some guy with a knife, how would you like to find yourself first person and singular?
Now we're going to go to a playpen.
That's dehumanizing what you did.
We do it to everybody.
I am not an ordinary person. When are you going to accept that fact?
Inside.
Ordinary people do not swim the Atlantic Ocean.
When did you swim the Atlantic Ocean?
Next April, from Long Island to London.
It can't be done.
Tell that to Gertrude Ederle.
Hey, Fish, who's Gertrude Ederle?
She covered herself with grease and swam the English Channel. It's a shame that Bernice can't swim. She'd be all set.
my life I wanted to accomplish something. I could have settled for little things.
Would you like some tea?
Thanks.
I have a great admiration for you, Mr. Gusick.
You putting me on or something?
On the contrary. I really believe that you have the determination to swim from Long Island to London.
What's the difference between mankind and animals? Mankind aspires. Mankind reaches out to the stars. Mankind pursues impossible dreams.
And the world would be better for this, that one man stand and cover the stars, should fight with his last ounce of courage to reach the unreachable stars.
Hi there, pal. We've got a nice white car down below for you with a nice red light on it and a big horn that goes woo, woo.
I see you two know each other.
Very funny. Then how about a little smile?
Come on, let's go.
Wait a minute. I've got to get my wings.
Hey, you won't need them. We're going to drive you over.
Captain Miller, do you really want me to go with them?
You'll be all right, Mr. Gusick. Oh, Joe, give him his wings. We're here to enforce the law, not shatter a man's visions.
Did you hear that? I'm ready now. Mr. Jeffers, if you ever get out again, look me up.
I'll be looking up at you.
Mr. Jeffers, I just spoke with somebody in the Attorney General's office. They tell me that if you hung around long enough, you could be eligible for parole in a couple of years. Think you can stand it?
A couple of years. It's longer now than it used to be.
Ooh, be tough, but said it yourself. Breaking out of jail can't be much of a challenge anymore.
I'll try to remember that.
Barney, this is Lieutenant Faraday. He's here to pick up Mr. Jeffers.
Captain. Well, so this is Jeffers, the happy wanderer. Well, we'll see what we can do about that. Come on, get a car downstairs.
No hard feelings, Mr. Jeffers, huh?
None at all, Mr. Shadow. Mr. Harris, I wish you good luck with your book, and maybe someday I'll write one myself.
Chapter 2 is all you. See you around.
Perhaps.
I have Thursday in the pool.
That's funny.
Gentlemen, Captain Miller, I want to thank you for your hospitality. This is the best time I've ever done.
Have a good trip back to Attica.
No. No more Attica. We got a special place for him.
Really?
Yes, we're going to Greenhaven. We've got a specially designed cell just for you. It's 100% escape proof.
Please don't say that.
It's already been tested. It's guaranteed to see that whoever goes inside stays inside.
I really wish he hadn't said that.
You don't have to listen to him.
Come on, Jeffers, I haven't got all day.
Just a moment, please. I believe these are yours. I'm gonna sail away and leave you, never to return, so you
can have it. Dono, Yamano, make sure he gets in the car.
Right.
Did he come in here?
Who?
That cuckoo bird. He kicked my partner in the groin and ran down the alley.
Oh, you guys help him find him, will you?
I don't believe
Barney.
This.
Hey, Barney!
What?
That Gusek, he got away from the ambulance
I
guys,
know.
Man. But he's up on the roof with the wings, man. He's trying to fly. He's gonna jump off the roof.
Hello, dispatcher. Yeah, get the fire department over here, will you? We got somebody up on the roof threatening to jump. Yeah, all right, we're going to need some nets.
Barney.
Yeah, hold it.
He jumped.
Oh, my God. Was he killed?
Nope. He just flew all the way to the ground. Sailing in a big circle. Just as pretty as anything you ever saw. Landed right in front of the ambulance.
What'd they do with him?
They took him to Bellevue.
I don't know what for. Detectives Amangual and Wojo Howitz. Arrest. Spelled your name wrong again, Wojo.
Don't believe it. You spell it the way it sounds. Wojo Howitz.
Amangual, Wojo Howitz arrested Jeffers in his apartment on a tip from an undisclosed source.
See that? And you weren't even there. How are you going to explain that when your book comes out? I, me, myself, I.
Hey, it's right here on the first page. Read the dedication. This bestseller is dedicated to the men of the 12th Precinct, without whom this story might never have been told. To Captain Barney Miller, Sergeants Amengual Fish, Yamana, and Detective 3rd Grade Wojo Howitz.
Your name is spelled wrong again. Barney, look at that spelling.
M-I-L-L-E-R looks okay to me.
This weekend and every weekend, turn to TV Land for a 48-hour nonstop marathon of one fine show. With all the best episodes all weekend long. TV Land Fandemonium Marathon Weekends. Always one thing on.